Welcome to the 2020 virtual graduation.
Good evening and warm wishes. I would like to begin by thanking several people for making this program possible. First, to Mr. Scardilli and his team for creating and scheduling our speeches tonight. Thank you to our entire school community for coming together in such a difficult time and finding ways to help promote our seniors whenever possible. To our Board of Education and administrators for their support of our students and programs here at ALJ. Altogether, we all help to make it a great place to learn and teach. To our students and staff for their help and guidance that they have provided for our students throughout their time here at ALJ. And finally, thank you to our parents for giving us such wonderful students to work with and for your support. Your children have made us all proud, and it is a reflection on you and how you have raised your children. Finally, to our students, class of 2020, you have made us all in school very proud, and we appreciate your hard work. Now to the favorite part of my speech, when I get to congratulate and recognize our students. I have known most of them, these young men and women, for almost 7 years, so I consider them pretty close to me. The young men and women of the class of 2020 are a truly remarkable group, spearheading and continuing programs and new initiatives such as the Blue Crew, Fall Kickoff Event, Friday Nights, Winter Blues, Pep Rallies, Heroes and Cool Kids, Peer Leadership and Clash of the Classes, and various fundraisers throughout the year. To see most of them grow and mature from shy little sixth graders to these outstanding graduates is truly a gift. Their work ethic, drive, and enthusiasm is a beacon and bright light shining on ALJ. They truly have left a positive mark here, and congratulations to all of our families, especially to our class of 2020.
Good evening. I'm Ed Grandy, our Superintendent of Schools, and I'm honored to be a part of the ceremony this evening. Congratulations, graduates. I'm going to begin by addressing the elephant in the room, so to speak, and the unfairness that your class was dealt with these past few months. As we all know, life can unfortunately be unfair at times, but it's how we deal with these situations that truly matters at the end. And you demonstrated to all of us how very well you're capable of overcoming challenges. You showed unity and immense success. A small example of your collectiveness and unity were those Instagram postings, and a larger proof of your immense success was the many awards and scholarships that your class obtained. These awards and scholarships were so very impressive in and of themselves. With everything that's going on in the world right now, always remember to choose kindness. As you reflect on your high school career, it can be difficult, but try not to focus as much on these past 3.5 months, but rather the 3 years and 6.5 months that preceded them. You always made us so very proud, and we know we're going to miss your presence in the fall. We have no doubt that you're going to continue to make us proud going forward, and we are looking forward to being on the field together on July 8th for a more traditional ceremony. The parents of Clark and Garwood, your teachers, other school personnel, the Board of Education, Mayor Bonacorso, and our larger community and townships are deserving of a very special thanks because they remained extremely committed to having us together on the field in July, and they never lost sight of that goal. Enjoy the rest of this virtual ceremony this evening. I know that I'm looking forward to it, and in particular, Bobby, Heidi's, and Taylor's speeches. And at all times, stay Crusader strong. Thank you and congratulations.
Robert W. Lukashevitz. Heidi Ann Compton. Nicole Rose Randazza. Taylor Marie Turek. Daniela Mary Thompson. Kaylee Ann O'Donnell. Emma Hilton. Nicholas Sean Sofianakos. Julia Patricia Shellhorn. Samantha Kate Piesco. Juliana Rose Abaticola. Gianna Nicole Nigro. Jordan Marie Walsh. Samantha Joe Spaziani. Mary H. Nadolski. Caitlin Greenhill. Patrick John Brennan. Ashley Priscilla Jimenez. Tara Marie Viafora. Sophia Madison Avila. Juan Carlos Acosta Lopez. Vicente Afonso. Justin Altamirano. Amy C. Arce. Shehab Badaway. Juliet L. Barakat. Sophia K. Bizink. Alexandra Lynn Bowen. Connor John Bowen. Kyle J. Recise. Emmy Budnick. Michael Henry Buttleman. Christopher Calabrese. Justin Anthony Calhoun. Stephanie Ray Campbell. Max R. Carmino. Vito Rocco Cassano III. Patrick Cassidy. Brandon Michael Clark. Joseph Manzo Connor. Sebastian Cortazzo. Katarina M. Costa. Kyle Justin Costa. Natalie Marie Kudo. Ashley Josephine Cucaro. John Gerard Cuculo. Leah Maria D'Angelo. Ashley Michelle Darling. Matthew Christopher DeLise. Nicholas A. DiLoretto. Olivia Francesca DiMartinez. Deanna Ashley Dennegan. Mia DeSantis. Anthony D. Diaz. Zachary Michael Dos Santos. Justin Alexander Dragonis. Edward Patrick Duffy. Jason A. Duffy. Caroline Amy Dymek. Liriel Lynn Erickson.
Hey everyone, and welcome to this virtual graduation for the ALJ class of 2020. So, if you know me, I live a pretty regimented lifestyle. From the moment I wake up, I'm usually busy. I study or read, go to school, club, sports, tutoring, library, gym, and then bed. And yes, while in part I live this way due to my impulse to overachieve, I also do it because I go crazy when I have free time. And in quarantine, with all this free time, my brain has acted like a circuit board would if you poured a bucket of water onto it. See, when I have free time, I tend to overthink, and this has come to fruition in the form of an insane amount of post-it notes all over my room. These post-it notes are a meticulous life plan for the next 40 plus years of my life. Now take this idea of the post-it notes and just hold on to it for a moment. My favorite subjects in school are history and English. And yes, while I love these subjects for the typical reasons, like the importance of history and its effects on the present dynamics of society and the morals novels teach us, I also like them for different reasons. There is something comforting in the fact that history does not change. The past is definite. For example, take the fact that the Declaration of Independence was signed on July 4, 1776. I know this fact and it will always be true. The same idea applies to books. The characters and the world that the author created will always be the same. The book will always begin with the same sentence and end with the same word, no matter what. Now, what do these two things, my insane amount of post-it notes that plan out my future, and my love of the definite humanity show you? This shows you how I hate change. I always want to be prepared for it. Personally, I would describe change as someone circle-punching you and hitting you with a car at the same time. It comes out of nowhere and really just flips your life upside down. Now, that makes change sound inherently bad, which it's not. It's actually very good. It's just a lot to deal with. Change, you know the cliche, change is the only constant in life. There is change that you can control, however, such as where you go to college, and change that you can't, like this pandemic. And at a high school graduation, I think there's no better theme than change, because I think that's what the purpose of the last 12 years of our life was. Because newsflash, high school wasn't about learning the quadratic formula, or analyzing Shakespeare, or learning about the American Revolution for the 100th time. Not only do we change for the better because of high school, but we become better at dealing with change. I don't know about you, but I was one crappy freshman. I mean, personally, I look back at my freshman self, and the first thing I think is, ew, and man, was I an uptight and annoying and ugly. We come into this building being dependent on our parents, not having the skills to really survive in the real world and to adapt to life on our own. Hopefully, we come out of this building smarter, but more importantly, we come out as better people knowing how to deal with change. We come out knowing how to think critically. We have a deeper worldly perspective. We are better listeners and team workers. And all of this helps us be better than our crappy freshman year selves. This year, more than ever, has shown how far we've come. We didn't really get a senior year. A global pandemic was the metaphorical sucker punch that knocked us all off our feet. And yes, prom dresses will collect dust in the closet never to be properly worn for their intended occasion, and the auditorium was empty on scholarship nights and induction ceremonies. But in this time of change, all of the growth from the past years have helped us not only cope with the pandemic, but think of creative solutions to still celebrate our senior year. While some of us might have cried or acted irrationally angry when our parents said good morning to us some days, we have mainly dealt with this situation with flying colors. Now, while graduation is a time of reminiscing, it is also a time to focus on the future. What will we do with these newfound abilities learned in high school? Society as a whole is on the cusp of so many changes, many of which we, as the next generation in control, will decide. The environment is being destroyed on the brink of total collapse. The healthcare and criminal justice systems are in need of reform, and people are wondering if capitalism is truly the best way for the American dream to survive. Most importantly, as we've seen recently, people in our country still aren't viewed as equals. Even in the 21st century, racism is rampant, and people are being unjustly killed because of the color of their skin. All of this needs action. It needs change. And this change will come from us. So that brings me to my last point. While high school has taught us to handle and deal with change, it has also taught us how to enact change. This is the most important type of change. It is not based on reaction, but on our ability to take action. Now I'll do some thank yous before I leave you with my last thought. Thank you to Superintendent Grande, Mrs. Feely, Mr. Bouchol, and all of the administrators for making our high school experience run smoothly. Thank you to all the teachers who have helped us become smarter and grow as people. Personally, I'd like to thank my family, specifically my mom, my twin Allie, and Uma, for putting up with me and supporting me throughout the past years. So, this brings me to my last thought. I believe from the bottom of my heart that each and every single one of us can change the world and do great things. With that, I'll ask you, not only what do you believe in, but what are you willing to stand up for and make a change?
Faith Teresa Gloria Fabrizio. Sean Patrick Thayer. Marissa Denise Feehan. Connor Fitzgerald. Catherine Mary Fitzharris. Kaylee Jade Follis. Nicholas Galati. Albert G. Galazuski IV. Brooke Ann Gallo. Patrick James Grady Jr. Alyssa Nicole Grasso. Emmanuel Gray. Maeve Gregorio. Grace Ann Gull. Lily May Gull. Katie Marie Hanna.
Carly Marie Hackett.
Stephen Vincent Harrington. Connor Austin Hayden. Janai Tanya Henry. Jeffrey Halongos. Justin Gary Halongos. Ronald J. Hone. James J. Honings. Cassandra M. Horner. Riley Scout Hummel. Sean Gregory Hurst. Samara Lynn Infantino. Aaron Isaiah Jeruzic. Patrick J. Johnson. Julia Adriana Kalinchuk. Matthew Peter Karna. Joseph Tyler Coffers. Amanda Marie Kefalis. Aiden L. Kelly. Lauren Cassidy Kelly. Caitlin M. Kesak. Benedict Koziak. Matthew Edward Koalenko.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Taylor Turek, and I'm the Vice President of the Class of 2020. I just want to start off by congratulating my fellow classmates for completing this ever so exciting chapter in our lives. For the first time, I now understand why people use the phrase in the blink of an eye when referring to the time spent in high school. Words cannot describe how surreal this feels, standing in front of my classmates and their parents, many of whom we have laughed and cried with over the years. For many of us, our journey started with big name tags and what seemed like oversized backpacks as we huddled together for our first day of kindergarten. We continued to welcome new members throughout the years to the graduating class of 2020. As we progress from elementary school to middle school, each and every one of us has unique and special bonds that we have been formed over the years with Johnson faculty, teachers, administrators, and coaches. On behalf of the class of 2020, we thank you for what you do best and the positive impact that you have had in our development over the years. The early morning labs, late night study sessions, and overwhelming amounts of homework all seem to be worth it now. To all of our teachers, thank you for being tough. Thank you for never giving up on us. Thank you for believing in us. And most importantly, thank you for the happiest memories and experiences of our life so far. My last thank you goes out to the most important and influential people in my life. Thank you, Mom and Dad and Joey, for always being by my side and guiding me throughout my journey. In eighth grade, I chose a quote for my yearbook, and never once did I realize how relevant this quote would be pertaining to the chaos the world is experiencing. Vivian Green, a British writer, once stated, "Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning to dance in the rain." We cannot simply say, let's turn a negative into a positive, because COVID-19 changed lives forever. It also altered our plans and the ideal senior year of high school that we have all heard stories about. What we can recognize is how this challenge has given the class of 2020 a common bond that we'll be able to share together. One thing that we've constantly hear this class from the influential people that we have crossed paths with is that we are free thinkers, resilient, and empathetic. Though we missed out on several senior activities such as prom, spring sports, end of year ceremonies, and our senior dinner, there's one thing that can never be taken from us. That is a common bond of this pandemic that has given us a new shared experience that did not break us, but instead made us stronger. I have two promises for my classmates. My first promise, years from now, we'll not sit back and commiserate on how the coronavirus ruined our senior year. Instead, we'll look back and embrace the new perspective and strength that we gained through the shared experience. Essentially, as seniors in high school, we learned an invaluable life lesson. Life is not fair. This is something that often we learn after graduation and many times have to face this challenge alone. We faced tough times and stood up to it. Most importantly, we did it together. The class of 2020 is united together forever. My second promise to you is that the memories and lessons learned over the years will never be forgotten and will allow us to succeed in the next chapters of our lives. Thank you all for the happiest years of my life. And as always, go Crusaders.
Ryan Nicholas LaRosa. Jenna Lynn Lancelotti. Richard A. Lapari. Jenna Rose Lapari Pazienza. Gabriella K. Lopez. Saul A. Lopez. Alexa Marie Lugo. Christopher Nicholas Manning. Gina Marie Marconi. Jonathan Stephen Moretta. Anthony J. Martucci. Kyle Matlos. Garrett Thomas McNellis. Dylan Joseph Mekovitz. Eric Malayo. Michael Medrano. Jesse Lee Minch. Jacqueline Alyssa Minetti. Michael A. Mirasol. Delia Rose Michel. Fabrizio Morales. Brianna Marie Muller. Shane Jet Mulroy. Nicole Elise Murin. Christopher Nudo. Dylan O'Shea. Mackenzie T. Oyola. Max Pachana.
Good evening. I would like to start by congratulating the entire class of 2020. Wow, what a ride it's been. I want to thank Superintendent Grande, Mrs. Feely, Mr. Bouchour, Mr. Amendola and the Guidance Department, Mr. Kalikas and the Athletic Department, the entire faculty and staff, the administration, and the Board of Education for a truly enlightening time in the Clark Public School District. Your help and support throughout our time at ALJ and the Clark School District has been a significant factor in much of our success. On a more personal note, I would like to recognize my family. Mom, Dad, Brianna, I want to thank you for the unconditional love and support you have given me for my entire life. I cannot believe I can stand up here and acknowledge all you do for me. Thank you. I also speak on behalf of the entire class of 2020 when I say that our deepest condolences go out to all those impacted by COVID-19. The vast majority of us have never experienced something so bizarre and tragic. We have all dealt with this situation in different ways, and it is something I hope nobody will ever have to live through again. I think it's time to address some of the better times during our journey throughout high school. There is, of course, the typical student life that everyone has experienced, waking up at 6:30 a.m. to get ready, rushing over to the school with probably the heaviest backpack you will ever wear, progressing throughout a stressful day filled with tests and assignments, eating lunch at a surprising 10:30 in the morning when most teenagers, including myself, probably still want to be asleep, going to sports or play practice or a club activity after school, making it home before it turns dark to finish homework, eat dinner, and go to bed at a somewhat reasonable time, all just to wake up the next day with maybe 5 hours of sleep. And then the cycle would continue along. So along with this daily grind comes so many special and heartwarming times that make it all worth it. The countless award ceremonies, our junior prom, state playoffs and championship games, and so many more. Now, I think it's pretty safe to say that this is consistent across most high schools in America. But what about these last 4 years at ALJ specifically? Well, I think we all remember the time we got to shave a few of the teachers' heads as a fundraiser. Or how about when we beat the teachers in tug of war? There was also the creation of the Active Minds Club by members of our own class of 2020. And then there was the time we threw wet paper towels at a horribly drawn target on the whiteboard. Don't worry, we didn't get in trouble for that. Mr. Grande was there with us that day, trying to teach us statistics about where they landed on the target. Now, I want you, the class of 2020, to think about some of the best moments in your high school experience. Maybe it was when you scored the game-winning goal, made the last tackle to get into the playoffs, got 100 on the hardest test of the year, or won a club election. Aside from any lessons learned or self-growth that came from these experiences, I just want you to remember how amazing it felt. I know in the future we all will probably be asked this question: what did you learn in high school? Well, if you want me to go into detail, I learned everything from American history to Newton's law of universal gravitation. Take this as an example. One of the questions on my last math test was, a lamina occupies a triangular region with vertices 1, 1, 1, 0, and 0, 1. Find the center of mass if the density is given by rho of xy equals y. Okay, first of all, I didn't even know what a lamina was before this test. But I've also got to ask, when on earth am I going to use this? I mean, maybe if I'm building replicated bone plates for patients in need of serious surgery. But what I really took from this problem was the fact that I was able to solve it. Persistence and determination are truly invaluable tools to take away from everything we have learned in high school. But what did we learn outside of academia? The first thought to my mind relates to friendships. I mean, let's face it, our time in high school was largely influenced by our friendships with those in our grade. There are our best friends, whom we trust virtually anything, our friendly acquaintances, our school and sports friends, and then our peers. Never in my life would I have thought that one of the most meaningful things I would learn in school is how to interact and bond with those around me. Now, obviously, we aren't going to become best friends with everyone we meet, but the communication skills acquired will definitely help with building connections for the future. And let's not forget about our interactions with the teachers and other adults in the school system. This was essentially a practice run for real life. We all have to deal with equals in our classrooms and those who have authority over us, being our teachers and the faculty. I like to think that high school is meant to teach us both academically and about life. Take the situation with the coronavirus. We, as a society, had to learn how to adapt to the new situation. A famous quote by Thomas S. Monson, which I shockingly found in a fortune cookie a few weeks ago, read, "We cannot direct the wind, but we can adjust the sails." Now, we can interpret this any way we want, but I think it means that as people move into the adult world, we are capable of change, if the situation calls for it, such as doing our part to help stop social injustice and systemic racism. Between our time at ALJ and our unprecedented senior year, I think we are all well-equipped for any curveball the future may throw at us. Ultimately, high school has built us all into role models who will go on to make great change. Now, I'm not going to stand up here and say that these past 4 years were the best time of your life, and I'm also not going to stand up here and say they were the worst time of your life. Each person out here had a different set of achievements and obstacles faced throughout high school. Maybe you received an award for the most service hours. Maybe you didn't act on the true potential you hold. My point is that everyone blooms at their own time in life. What I mean is, if you look back on high school and think of nothing but excitement, use that as momentum, which I now know what is thanks to Dr. G, as you move forward. If the idea of high school only brings up conflicting memories, use that as the driving force. As we all move on from high school, let's keep everything we learned, but we don't have to let these 4 years in high school define us for the rest of our lives. I know we will all go on to pursue our passions. Even though the sun has set on our time at ALJ, I know we will bring all of these memories with us on our next chapter in life. And I want to leave you all with this to think about. Even if you didn't do everything you wanted to in high school, or don't know what you want to do in the future yet, don't worry. We will all have the chance to achieve something amazing. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2020 of ALJ.
Jerome W. Palmer. Evan Parenti. Jillian Hensinger. Emily Marie Pereira. Danielle Ashley Iris Petronella. John Alexander Petrucci Jr. Anthony Planter. Alexa Prestonari. Gabriella Prestonari. Sarah Radwan. Noelia Adriana Ramirez. Shaylin Alyssa Rapp. Gabriel Christian Reynoso. America J. Renteria. Andre Resendez. Victoria Marie Rivera. Gina R. Rizzuto. Emma Renee Rocco. Kyle G. Sakowitz. Sky Olivia Center. Jack Kenneth Smolinski. Matthew Willard Snedeker. Charles Joseph Sona. Tara Starita. Nicole Sispanska. Ralph Joseph Tallarico Jr. Isabella Tallow. Megan Janina Tinger. Angeli Valdez. Hannah Rose Vargas. Isabella Lee Venezia. Isaias Gabriel Viteri. Dominic Vito. Tyler Isaiah Washington. Jenna Renee Weiss. Cody Ryan Williamson. Emily Woods. Tyree J. Worbitz. Yahiri A. Yoplek, Andy Zhang, one last time, have a great day, and as always, go Crusaders!
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know where.